Ah, light. It lets us marvel at the vibrant colors, intricate details, and beauty of cultural heritage objects. But too much light will also degrade the chemical bonds of dyes and pigment, leading to a loss of color. Understanding an object's sensitivity to light is crucial for collection care. Traditionally, heritage institutions have followed general guidelines for light sensitivity based on the types of colorants and materials used in objects, such as plant and insect-based colors, ballpoint inks, feathers and furs, modern permanent paints, and mineral pigments. But these broad categories of sensitivity can overlook variations within each type, or the materials in the object may not be known. Prior exposure to light can also impact light sensitivity, because a lot of materials are more sensitive when they're in pristine condition. So how can we evaluate an individual object's sensitivity to light? In the mid-1990s, conservation scientist Paul Whitmore had a bright idea and introduced a method for assessing light sensitivity called the Microfading Tester, or MFT. The MFT exposes each color on an object's surface to a spot of light that is smaller than the tip of a pencil and 10 times brighter than the midday sun, while at the same time measuring color change with a spectrometer. But don't worry, the method safeguards the object from damage by stopping each test before you can see any color change. No harm, all insight. By testing the object itself, the MFT reveals the light sensitivity of its specific palette of colors given its history of light exposure. The elevated light intensity also allows color change to be measured quickly, so you can screen the light sensitivity of multiple objects being considered for display. The analysis of MFT data predicts how the colors of an object will shift when exposed to light. This knowledge supports the development of data-driven lighting policies that balance preservation and access. For light-sensitive objects, the light intensity can be reduced, the display time shortened, or both. On the other hand, less sensitive objects can be safely shown at higher light levels and/or for extended durations. The microfading tester is used at heritage institutions around the world and has proven to be an important preventive conservation tool. It empowers collection care staff to better manage the risk of color change during display, guide the selection of cultural heritage objects for exhibition, and allow for greater access to these objects for the public, both now and in the future.